Hi guys, follow me on Instagram to never ever miss any of my crazy updates. Hi guys and welcome to another vlog. I am driving this. This is the Maruti Omni right in front, and this seems to be the face favorite model because the original model, which was launched in 1985, had round lights. This one has sort of rectangle lights, plastic bumper. I think it goes off-roading a lot. That's why a lot of mud and stuff is lying on it, splashes and stuff like that. Suzuki logo over here. There's no grill, they just put some plastic over here. It doesn't need a grill because this is a rear engine, rear wheel drive. In fact, on Maruti's website, it says twin wipers as a feature. Yes, that's right. Twin wipers is a feature on this vehicle. Indicators below, lights over here, not powerful at all. Internally adjustable rear view mirrors with your hand, obviously. An antenna, which has to be manually operated. A lot of accessories on this car, like a rain visor over here. And Omni stickers are standard on this vehicle. It also gets wheel caps, which are aftermarket. By the way, these are 12-inch tires. I'm not kidding. 12-inch, the smallest in any car, bar the Nano, of course. And as you can see, it also gets Sparco accessories. So this mud flap says Sparco over here. This actually increases the downforce of this vehicle. This is the fuel lid of this vehicle. From the side, it's not really long. It's just 3.3 meters long, which makes it very short. In fact, this is really a small car. The spare wheel is placed over here underneath. It's not an alloy, and you can see the leaf springs at the rear. Well, 35 liter fuel tank, and from the rear, the design is kind of bland. It's actually a van. It's like a, yeah, that's how it is. Exhaust pipe is so small. Look at the exhaust pipe. It's really small. In fact, the diameter of the bottle from which I drink water is bigger. So these are actually the reverse lights over here, and brake lights, indicators, reflectors, whatnot. Plastic lighting over here. Omni E written over here. E is not for electric. E is for efficiency. E is for I don't know what. So inside you get these sun blinds. Anyways, too much noise happening over here. I'm so sorry about that. So the stance of this vehicle is very nice. In fact, this can go from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour in 2 seconds down a cliff, of course, but it doesn't really reach 100 as such, unless and until you're lucky. Let's open the boot. So this one is an LPG or a CNG or whatever it is. I don't know. Didn't bother to check as such. Oh my God. It just comes on to you.
That's what she said.
Lovato, this is an aftermarket kit probably. And as you can see, there's no boot space because of this. So let's just close this right away. And actually there's no button as such to close it. You have to do it manually. So here, let me lock it. Yeah, lock. No central locking, which means you have to manually open stuff. I mean, I'm doing a lot of exercise today. So sliding doors, these are perfect for kidnapping. In fact, this is also known as the kidnap vehicle, but it's going to be replaced by another kidnap vehicle. Now this is an 8-seater. It's also available as a 5-seater, and there are two more variants on offer, which happen to be cargo and ambulance. So the wheel caps which were put here, this is the box of the wheel cap. It shows a BMW car on top. That happens to be the 5 series. Yes, set of 4 pieces. Accessories that enhance the value of your vehicle. In fact, this wheel cap on this vehicle makes the power go up by almost 0.002 HP. So there's a big subwoofer over here. This is an 8-seater as such. So, you know, at one time only one person can get leg room and knee room. There is no under thigh support. You can see my feet are almost touching the camera. Yeah, that's the condition over here. Meanwhile, if you want to hang your clothes to dry them, you can do it over here. There's a fan over here. Well, wow, the traditional fan. And easy operation to close the door. That's really nice. In order to open it, press this button and there it goes. This sliding mechanism works so fast that it enables 20% faster kidnapping compared to traditional methods. As you can see, the seats are not seats, they're just benches. There's no headroom, there's no headrest, there's no center armrest, there's nothing of that sort. These windows do not open either. This window does open. You have to press this button and there it opens. And these are sliding mechanism over here. Let's quickly change position and sit on the other side. As you can see, well, it is extremely hot because of the black seats and the weather as well. But these headrests at the front can be used as rear headrests also. So person sitting here can use these headrests. So these are dual headrests. This is a proprietary technology which has been patented, that using one headrest for two people. That is just amazing. As you can see, there's not much space as such over here because of it being an 8-seater. Three people can sit here, three people can sit here, two people can sit there, and maybe four people can hang from the doors. But the doors are sliding, so four people are hanging from the door. They might be kidnapped, or either they have to kidnap. But if they kidnap someone, where will they put them exactly? Anyways, that doesn't matter. As you can see, there are no seat belts on offer over here for the six passengers who are sitting over here. So it's not really safe as such. However, as you can see, the body of this vehicle is also not that great. It's not going to really meet BS6 emission norms. So it's going to be discontinued, and Eco is going to take over from there. There's a handle to hold on to over here, exposed wires and stuff like that. There's actually a seat belt mechanism over here. Although I can't understand why there's no seat belt mechanism over here. It's kind of weird. Anyways, let's get out from over here. Easy ingress and egress. As you can see, there is an indicator over here. Easy sliding mechanism. I think I should do a boomerang of that. That's so freaking cool. Anyways, the driver sits on the wheel itself. And again, there's no central locking, there's no power window, there's none of that sort. You know, this is the wheel. You actually sit on the wheel. Let me see if I can position the seat a bit towards the back. No, it is difficult to adjust this seat, although I think it does move a bit. Seatbelt is going to hold you onto the vehicle because you sit so close to the windscreen and there's no hood on offer. So there's a cup holder over here, there are a lot of switches over here. This is to switch between petrol and natural gas, of course. And this is actually to turn on the fan. This is the headlight level. This one doesn't get a rack and pinion steering. Yeah, that is right, no rack and pinion steering over here. In fact, it gets a gear head below for the steering wheel, and that makes it slightly difficult to work on. As you can see, there's no door pocket on offer. There's a power window switch over here. Handbrake is positioned over here. There's a center armrest as such. I don't know exactly what it is. There's a glove box over here, which is, by the way, lockable, and right now it is locked. So let's open it right away. Here we go. There you go. Good amount of space on offer, but you know, you have to lock the glove box, otherwise it will keep opening. These are dummy places for the air conditioning vents. It gets no air conditioning as such. And over here, there's space to keep stuff over here. There's a music system which has been added aftermarket as well. So let's quickly get inside. Now, this is a real challenge inside the vehicle. Now, the problem with this vehicle, the biggest problem I'm facing right now, is that the pedal positioning is like this, okay? So it actually pains your knees in stop-go traffic. No auto dimming inside rear view mirror. In fact, there's no switch also over here to switch the mirror. And you can see the sun visor is like really very small. There's a light placed over here, which, by the way, works. Sun visor over here, there's no mirror on offer. Headroom isn't great, seats are not that great either. And as such, this isn't a very comfortable vehicle. Now, you can see this instrument cluster gets a temperature meter on the leftmost. On the rightmost, we get a fuel meter. And in the center, we get the speedometer along with the odometer. This car has done 57,000 kilometers. Telltale lights are placed all over the place. The horn doesn't work when the vehicle is turned off. This is actually the switch for the headlight. This is actually the switch for the wipers. Meanwhile, let's quickly turn on the vehicle. The temperature meter swipes up and tells you exactly what is our engine temperature right now. And oh my god, it's really very hot. The horn is really loud because you are actually sitting around the horn itself. That's another thing. There's a 12 volt charging socket over here. There are a lot of wires. I don't know for what is the handbrake. Let's put it down. Yeah, handbrake is down right now. And honestly, I mean, you are just sitting upright like this. Steering wheel is similar to the one on the Mercedes S-Class pre-facelift model, 2 spokes over here. Let's use the wipers over here. Now, the thing is, it is spraying. You have to manually operate the wipers separately. And yes, the motor makes a lot of noise. It is extremely slow as well. So that's that. And it gives a good view of what's around. Let's quickly belt up right away. So seat belt on right now. And it is time to start driving. So let's turn on the vehicle, and it turns on making a lot of sound because the engine is nearby itself. It's a rear engine, actually, rear wheel drive. There's a lot of vibrations on offer here. Let's turn on the fan right now. There it is, the fan. Oh, what relief that is, but very noisy. The gearbox is supremely clunky and it has a lot of chewing gum. It's very notchy. In order to get into reverse, well, it is almost impossible. Now we are into reverse. Handbrake is down. Getting into first gear is fine. Getting into second is impossible. It just doesn't get into second. A lot of exposed wires as well. Now we are into first gear. Yes, we are all set to go. Revving the motor, traction control off, launch control active, and here we are. Progress is extremely slow, but hard onto the throttle, burning the throttle, and it goes all the way till almost 40 kilometers per hour in first, making a lot of noise. We've got into second, clap, 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 and now revving the motor. As you can see, the engine is quite smooth. Now, this is a 796cc motor. It's a 3-cylinder engine. It has 2 valves per cylinder, total of 6 valves on offer. Produces 35 horsepower at 5000 RPM and 59 Newton meters of torque at 2500 RPM. Yes, the motor is quite refined as such. It pulls also cleanly and nicely because this is a light car. It weighs just 800 kgs, but the steering has absolutely no feel or feedback. Just look at the steering. I mean, you can actually dance with the steering. That's the level of feel and feedback from the steering. A lot of body roll. Every time you turn, you're going to pray for your life that you don't topple. That's the kind of handling on offer. But this isn't the vehicle to be pushed around into corners as such. As you can see, the brakes are very shabby. I mean, every time I get into the brakes, I pray 1000 times that it stops, because the brakes are very poor on this vehicle. Tire size is also very small, not much grip on offer. And getting into second is a big challenge. Like I told you, the gearbox is in smooth. Now, this is made it to a 4-speed gearbox. It's not a 5-speed, it's a 4-speed gearbox. And my goodness, the ride isn't great either. Now, obviously, with one person in the car, the ride isn't great. If you have more people in the car, the ride will definitely be better because of the leaf springs at the rear. Meanwhile, the best thing about the Omni is that you can flick through traffic because it gives you a good view of what's around you. So you can actually see everything around you very cleanly and very nicely, thanks to the fact that this vehicle has no hood at all. So you can actually see your maneuvering points as such. It gets a 35 liter fuel tank. Fuel economy is good. It returns around 15 to 17 kilometers per liter, which is respectable as such for a vehicle of this class and size. And that brings me to the variants on offer. There are 4 variants on offer. There's an 8-seater, this is an 8-seater, there's a 5-seater. None of them get air conditioning. There's a cargo, which is for commercial, and there's an ambulance variant as well. Now, the pricing is common for almost all the variants, I believe, at least for the 5 and 8 seater. It is 3.58 lakhs or 3.60 lakhs if you want the 8 seater. And overall performance, well, it's fine. The dynamics are rubbish though. It just doesn't go straight in line. You have to keep correcting the steering wheel. That is one big problem on offer over here. And it's very noisy. The cabin is extremely noisy. You can hear a lot of sound and it just doesn't feel refined in any possible way. Yes, for a Maruti engine, I expected more refinement, but still, by van standards, the engine is actually the highlight of this package because there's good amount of low end punch. It does scream in near the red line because every time I go hard onto the throttle, I can hear a lot, and there you can see how much noise it makes. This motor is very noisy. Now, I'll tell you what is the best feature about this car. It is actually the turning radius. The turning radius is just 4.1 meters. That's right, 4.1 meters is a very narrow turning radius. I mean, you can take a turn anywhere you want. Here you go. That is how you can take a turn. And in first gear, revving the motor full throttle. Come on, baby, show me what you've got. Okay, other than noise, come on, show me some movement. Oh God, when I near the red line, I feel the engine is going to blast any moment on me. So as you can see, the Omni is going to be discontinued next year. Yeah. Because this car has a lot of issues. I mean, it feels like a massive compromise. You can hit a top speed of 100 kilometers per hour, close to 100 kilometers per hour, but you have to be absolutely brave and have at least 5 insurance policies, one for your personal life as well. So around the corners, I kind of feel sure-footed with the body roll, but I don't know where I'm pointing. I have to keep correcting the steering. I actually feel like a Formula One driver, you know, giving a lot of steering inputs. Good ground clearance on offer actually. And here we go. Okay, I've stalled. That is bad, Faisal. You have driven almost every car, and how can you stall an Omni? Now, you know, what will this do to your reputation? People will be like, usko gaadi chalani nahi aati. Cut this part and edit. Okay, done, boss. Edit. Ho gaya. Chalo, let's go. Here we go. Come on, baby. Give me what you got. First gear, 40 behind the second. Oh my God. Woo! Okay, relax. Don't get overexcited, overzealous. People will be like, kitna chillata rehta. Chillane ke siwa isko kuch aata hai kya? Anyways, guys. Okay, the horn is something which really excites me because I feel I'm honking to myself to make me alert because it's inside the vehicle. That's the condition of this vehicle. I just wished I had this car for a longer time because if I did, then probably I would have gone kidnapping people and that would have been so freaking cool, you know. The only thing is, once you kidnap someone, they can catch you because this car has no power to run away either. That's it, guys. I hope you like this video of mine, and if you did, okay, we are planning an overtake. All players, fingers crossed. Here we go. Can we do it? Can we do it? Can we do it? Oh no, people are coming around us. And there's a speed breaker on offer. Will the car stop? Applying the brakes. Applying. Oh my God, there's a parachute which needs to be put out from a... It won't get into second. Get into first. From first to second, you can go. You cannot go direct into second. Do you know that? There's a rule. You just cannot go into second directly. You have to go into first, then you come into second. That's how the whole gearbox works in this vehicle. So guys, every time I get on the throttle, I wonder what's going to happen next. Come on, Omni. Come on, babes. What's up? Leather wrapped steering. Take that, bitches. Okay, I love taking U-turns in this car somehow. I don't know why. U-turns, get into first, get into second. You can't directly get into second, you know that, right? Four-speed gearbox. This car has served India for a real long time. 1985 was when it was launched, and it sold, I think, around 15 million units or so. Lot of vehicles on the road, the Omni, especially because of the price tag. Now, I'm taking a U-turn, I don't have to worry because I know it's just going to make it. There's no power steering on offer. So, oh my God, come on. Here we go, rear wheel drive. And that is the power and magic of a rear wheel drive vehicle. Okay, now I won't get into second. Now we are into second. I don't know how the gearbox is so rubbish. I mean, it's absolutely atrocious. Feeling hot, let's turn on the fan. No, turn off the fan, you'll get more power. That's a lot of noise for a car, honestly. There's no insulation, there's no concept of NVH over here. It's just a vehicle with 4 wheels and 8 seats. That's about it. That is the Maruti Omni for you guys. And if you like this video, you know what you have to do. Give it a thumbs up. That's a like button. I think the next van I'm going to drive is the Mercedes V-Class. Bye-bye. We will stop. No. It's not stopping. Oh, my God. Oh, that was just drama.